from the first school day in with new and high definition. This is 9 News Now.
And it's Friday. That means our Mind of the Money segment is back. We have live experts on hand to take your financial questions. The number to call is 202-432-9045. They're ready to grab that phone right now.
Make that
left behind. This morning, our Mind Over Money segment is back, and we want you to meet our experts. Larry Finkelberg and Terry Green are here. They're talking about housing, and you can call Joe Gallagher for investment questions.
Susan Samico can help you plan for retirement, and Jennifer Streaks can help you bail out of credit card debt. Once again, the number to call, and you can start dialing right now, is 202-432-9045.
There's next after the collapse. Could recovery be the key word for the housing market in 2009? Those are the key questions on the minds of prospective home buyers and sellers in our area and across the country. We've got two housing experts in Broadcast House this morning. Larry Finkelberg is with the Mayor Home Lending, and we welcome Terry Green, branch manager of Allied Home Mortgage Capital Corporation. We just got a phone call, and I want to talk to you about this, and either one of you can jump in. You know, somebody calling, they owe about $3,000 on their mortgage, and they're behind. They're worried they're going to get tossed out. What steps should they take?
First thing is always to reach out to the bank that's holding the mortgage. At this point, their inventories are through the roof. They do not want to foreclose. So calling, and they even have modification departments set up. So you're going to want to call into the bank, ask them to restructure. They can spread out the arrearages, perhaps adjust the interest rate or the term of the loan to help you work things out and stay in the home, because they don't want to foreclose any more than you want to be foreclosed on.
And this is one of those cases where silence is not golden. You've got to communicate, right, Terry?
Absolutely, absolutely. The thing to do is to go through your budget, make sure you know how much you can afford to pay on all your bills every month, so you're armed with that information when you call the lender, and then you have all your budget worked out, and they'll work with you. They do not want to take the house.
Now, you and I had a chance just to talk briefly here. You're talking about a unique way to buy a house. So what were you saying?
Yeah, right now, all the news is bad about foreclosures and that there's nothing but bad news out there. And a lot of people who qualify for homes are shying away because they're afraid with the economy they're going to lose their job and not be able to afford their house. Now you can get insurance programs that come with the loans. We offer that. A lot of other lenders do, where you buy a home and with your mortgage is insurance that if you get terminated from your job, you know, fired, then you'll have insurance to pay up to 6 months of your mortgage at $1,800 a month. Now that's something you don't get if you rent. So the people that are renting thinking, I'm gonna ride out the storm, they're missing the boat. They can buy a house, you got historically low interest rates, you got house prices that are as low as they've ever been. Now's the time to buy, and the insurance programs make it really easy to do.
That's very smart, and a lot of people aren't thinking about that, are they? Let me ask you, you know, you came in with pastries this morning. Let's move the pastries out of the way, which you're trying to ruin our resolutions. But let me ask you about your projection from 2009. Obviously, it can't get any worse than 2008. That's what a lot of people are saying. If you look in your crystal ball, what do you see as far as a shakeout?
Well, let me disclaimer, I'm an optimistic person, but I do feel like with the fact that interest rates are as low as they are, we're about 5 1/8% right now on 30-year fixed, the government's intervention and the huge stimulus that's going to be coming, I feel like we might be able to find some sort of bottom, perhaps in the spring market. Now, we are not going to have a recovery that resembled anything we had back in 03, 04, 05. It's going to be very modest. We could drag along the bottom for a while. But once that occurs and people feel confident that the home values have bottomed out, things will start a gradual recovery, and I'm optimistic it'll happen this year.
Terry, I believe in the fairness doctrine, so I'll give you a shot at the same question.
Well, I believe Larry's right. We're not going to see anything like we saw in 03, but house prices are very low. Opportunities are huge right now. Interest rates are, like I said, historic lows, high fours, low fives. Everyone is starting to look at the opportunity to buy homes again, and it is going to start picking up again. It's going to be slow, but it will start picking up. And as long as you hold on to your house, your value will come back.
And anecdotally, what are you seeing out there? And I'll ask you the same question. We'll start with you.
I'm seeing, you mean in terms of
what, people coming in? Is it trickling in? Or are you
it's
seeing
coming in faster? It is starting to come in a lot better now because of the low interest rates. The refis are coming back a little bit, but people are starting to buy houses again. And, you know, they're optimistic about it because there's opportunities. And we're seeing a lot more activity than we've seen in the last 6 to 12 months.
Larry, you get the final word.
Certainly, from a refinance standpoint, there's been a huge influx of business as of late, and rightfully so. I mean, again, with rates dipping into the fours for a while. And I think on the purchase side, I think people are starting to ease into it. There's still a lot of fear about their job and everything. But, you know, if things start to stabilize, I think we'll gradually be in good shape here.
All right, Larry and Terry, we're going with the rhymes this morning. Thank you both for coming on. I'll let you
Thanks,
get back
Mike.
To the phone. Still to come on 9. Well, there's no more fighting over who gets the house in a messy divorce case. Instead, many couples are fighting to keep from getting stuck with the property. That's because of the housing slide. Larry Finkelberg from Amera Home Lending is back now with us. We also have Terry Green from Allied Home Mortgage Capital Corporation. Of course, we're referring to a piece in the New York Times where they're saying a lot of times people are so upside down on the homes that it used to be they'd battle over who got the assets from the home. Now it's who's going to get stuck with the home. In fact, in this article, they talk about how these couples, in some cases, it's like the War of the Roses, mm-hmm. where they're really angry with one another, but they can't move out because they're upside down in the home. So the husband's upstairs with his girlfriend and the wife's downstairs with the boyfriend. It sounds crazy. But can you give some, if we have one of these cases out there, which I hope we don't, can you give them some reassuring words?
It's funny. I mean, I remember years ago this would happen, and it was literally people were killing each other to see who would get the house, and now it's just the opposite. But unfortunately, there really isn't a lot that you can do if you're upside down. I mean, short of doing a negotiation with the bank, which they may be willing to do in the case of a divorce, but I would urge people to look at it from a long-term point of view. I mean, I understand that things are bad right now, but if you're going to hold the home long-term, it is going to go back up in value. And if people can look a little more long-sighted, you know, it might make sense to buy the other partner out, especially if it keeps the relationship amicable. And down the road, it'll be a good investment.
Yeah, it's interesting because one of the articles, in the article, they talked about how the value of this one home in the Atlanta area was like over $1 million, and now it's like worth nothing. And so if you buy them out at this price and not the, you know,
right.
that's causing. Terry, tell me about, you got an interesting call from one of our viewers in Maryland. Tell us about that.
Jennifer from Maryland called. She has a house that she bought with no money down. She has two loans, one at 6% and one at 7 3/8. And their financial situation has turned around, and they're actually making good money now, and they have a surplus of funds. She wanted to know whether she should pay the mortgage off quicker, and you know the house is worth less than the sum of the two loans now, or if she should put the money towards her kids' future. And in her case, I was saying, you know, since they have the surplus of income, they need more write-off. So I'd say put the money in one of those plans that protects the money for the kid's future, because she's going to keep the kids for a long time, but I suspect she won't be keeping the house forever. And then just keep the payments because they're comfortable. Make the payments on the mortgage and just keep the house and waiting for the market to turn around, but put that extra money towards their kids because that'll be a much better plan for her.
I completely agree with Terry. I mean, once you put money into a house, and I'm not suggesting paying your mortgage down is a bad thing, but it's not liquid anymore. It's gone. And the only way you can get it out is selling or refinancing. In these tough times, cash is king. So, you know, make your mortgage payments, but keep as much out and stay as liquid as you can in the event you lose a job or something down the road. So absolutely the right strategy.
And we have a friend who had a 15-year mortgage, and now they're looking at a 30-year mortgage because that's going to reduce the price for all the same sort of thing. But let's talk about that. A lot of these people, it all seems defensive now and not mm-hmm. offensive. And we were talking about this. Everything seems fear-based. And really, if people would just calm down, that might help, right?
Absolutely. And that's part of why it's a self-fulfilling prophecy. I mean, people are afraid to buy because values are going down and everything's feeding on this panic. And it's just it's a death spiral. And, you know, people have got to understand that we're in a tough time, but there's a lot of opportunities, whether you're talking in equities or in the housing market, to buy now and really make some good money down the road.
So, Terry, if you've got a house, you're thinking, geez, you know, maybe I want to put it on the market and sell it. Patience, I guess, is the key word, right?
Patience is the right thing because the market will turn around and just turn off the TV, except for Channel 9, of course, because you're the only ones out there spreading the good news, because it's just fear on all the different channels. And that's exactly what they need to do. Just be patient, take your time, and do the smart thing.
Well, the producer said we can say bye after this when you said turn off the television set. Luckily, you saved yourself, but thank you both. Don't turn the TV off, geez. Now I'm fearful. Okay, still.